Welcome to another video. I am Dr. Vishal. The chance of getting admission into a medical college and becoming a doctor is no less than getting a chance of going to Hogwarts and becoming a wizard of potions and magic. Because the craft that you learn is something which has been developed over many years of perfection and experimentation by people who are obsessed with understanding human body. However, there are a few pointers that I would like to give you if you are somebody who is about to enter a medical college. So the first thing that I want you to know is that you should start preparing for the future as soon as you get into medical college. I was given this advice before, but I did not take it very seriously. And that is why I have taken this moment to tell you that you should not repeat those mistakes. As soon as you get into medical college, you have to plan what degree, what specialty, what projects, what research assignments, and what are the different exams that you have to give in the future. The trouble is that once you get into medicine, especially after so much hard work for NEET preparation and other exams, that you might become lazy or complacent. But let that not get into your way. As soon as you know what exams you have to give, you can start preparing for it slowly and steadily, not in full form like you do before exams, but it is very crucial to have a clear idea of what kind of branches, what country, what exam you are about to give in the coming 4 to 5 years so that you can prepare it accordingly. If you don't, then you will realize things later and spend many years preparing for those exams while others would have thought of this earlier and would progress in their professional and academic career earlier than you. So the first thing is that start looking into the future as soon as you get into your medical college. The second advice that I want to give you is that learn to become a team player. Why do I say so? It's because we all come from very competitive exams, and all of the people who enter medical college are the topmost students of their own schools. So we have competition built into our nature. But sometimes this competition is interpreted as working alone, and working alone is something which is not a good idea if you are going to become a doctor. As a doctor, it is very important for you to be a team player. And if you are not somebody who is a team player, then you have to take active effort to become a team player. Because in medicine, solo players finish last. Because you spend so much time in medical college that these friends which you make, which eventually turn to your team, will be by your side throughout your life. There are very few other professions in which you can spend so much time with your peers and friends in the college and have an elaborate relationship or a bond with them in times to come. 6 years of graduation, 3 years of post-graduation, 3 years of super specialization is a long amount of time that very less people are fortunate to get in college and in universities while studying. So make sure that you make enough friends and learn to play as a team. They will come to your rescue more often than you realize. Another thing I want to add is that always and always respect your teachers. The trouble with medicine is that people have very sharp memories and everybody is connected to everybody. So the teachers that you have been, let's say, tolerating today are the ones who are going to write your letter of recommendations in the future, and they are the ones who will guide you and teach you the tricks of the trade which you will eventually make your living from. If you have been watching the video this far, then let me tell you that I have partnered with this startup called Unheard, which is a Bangalore based company, and I have put up a mentorship program with them in which I can sit and leisurely tell you one-on-one what the life of a medical student is. Having spent so many years in medical college, I would be more than happy to give advice, share tips and insight and ideas of what it means to become a doctor. What is the life of a doctor these days in 2020? How things have changed, how things can be, and help you in deciding if this is the career for you. So this is what I have been doing with Unheard. And Unheard is a company which provides experiential learning, which essentially means that somebody who is interested in taking medicine can talk to a doctor before actually deciding to take up the profession. They also have mentorship programs with other professionals like a radio jockey, maybe a virologist, maybe a graphic designer, so on and so forth. So if you feel like you need to know more about this career, make sure you sign up for this mentorship program. You will find all the details in the description box below. Even if you don't feel like signing up, there is no harm. You can share the word with your friends, your family, or whoever can find this video or this idea useful. The third thing I want to tell you is that you will be judged all the time. Again, this comes from the fact that all the people who are in medical college are from the best of schools and are the smartest of their class. So the competition is very stiff, and the teachers over there want to know who is the best candidate, who is the one who is lazy, and so they are under the constant scrutiny of their teachers, and this is normal and this is accepted in medical culture. There are a lot of things in the medical culture that I will talk about in some other video which are not really healthy from a physical or a mental or an emotional point of view, but to say the least, the culture in medicine is there to stay, and almost all of years spent in medical college will be like a very long job interview where every day, every action, everything will create your impression, increase or decrease your impression in times to come. So be very mindful of what you are doing, what you are learning. Make sure you learn the right things. Make sure you pick up the right habits, like coming on time, being courteous with everybody, being well-mannered with everybody, respecting the patient, respecting your peers, seniors, everybody. All these small things create an image which will carry you henceforth in your professional life. These things have to be realized before you turn into a medical call. Another thing that I want you to understand is that the best way to learn inside a medical college is to live the life inside a medical college. By that I mean that if you're somebody who thinks that you will only attend lectures and study before exams like it is done in other branches, then you will not be making the most out of your medical college curriculum and life. I personally believe that most of the learning happens after the class is over. It happens when you're hanging around with the patients. It happens when you're hanging around the canteen. It happens when you're hanging around with your friends, chilling and talking and discussing about your topics, whatever you had studied, going out, applying, trying, testing, is when you actually become doctors, more often than what happens to you when you're sitting in the lectures and preparing and mugging and memorizing for the exams. So make sure that you live the life of a medical student. Go out of your way to learn things rather than just sitting and waiting for somebody to come and spoon feed them to you in your brain. Last but not the least, it is almost mandatory to have extracurricular habits if you are somebody who is going to pursue medicine. Because medicine as a profession is a very demanding profession, not just physically, but also emotionally. So there will be chances, there will be times where you will feel drained out, you will feel sad. Most of the time, almost in every other branch of medicine, your day begins with listening to somebody's complaint or somebody's pain or somebody's problem. After many months and years, you will realize that this can take a heavy toll on your emotional health. And hence, it is very important. It is, like I said, almost mandatory to have another set of hobbies or another set of activities which keep you balanced compared to the stress and the challenges which you face in your hospital. There are various hobbies like traveling, like how I like to make videos, like photography or like cooking or dancing or reading. And there are so many, but the point is that you should not lose sight of them while you are in medical college. And medical college is very long. It is almost 10 to 12 years of academic traditional training where there is no scope, no merit, no encouragement given for all your extracurricular activities. In fact, it is discouraged. But as a freshly minted doctor, let me tell you that had it not been for the extracurricular activities that I could hold on to, I would not have been able to balance myself. And same is the advice that I would like to give you. So that is it from me now. I hope you liked the video. If you would like to know more about what goes into the life of a doctor and how do things look from the other end, then make sure you subscribe to the channel. Like the video, share it with your friends and family, and I will see you in the next one.